In this introductory unit, I'll say what fractals are and give a number of different ways of thinking about fractals and self-similarity. The main technical content of this unit is the idea of the self-similarity dimension. You'll learn what this is and how to calculate this for simple mathematical fractals. So to get started in this video, what are fractals? Well, the first way to think about a fractal is that it's an object that's self-similar. And that means that it's made up of copies of itself, smaller copies of itself. So a classic example is this fern. Here's a fern shape. I picked it outside my office. And a fern is made up of smaller shapes that look like a fern. So these two things look not identical, but they're very similar shapes. You can sort of see that. Maybe this will work. So it's a shape that's made up of shapes that are similar to it. And it continues this self-similarity over several scales. Let's see if I can do this. So here's part of a fern. And this fern, part of the fern came from this. Those hopefully look a little bit similar. And then this looks like this. So fractals are objects that are self-similar. They're made up of smaller copies of themselves. And this self-similarity extends over several scales or several size generations. In contrast, a person, or the outside of a person, is not self-similar. So here's a person, or okay, not a person at all, and the arm of a person does not look like a small copy of a person. That'd be really creepy if it did. So we would say that this shape, a person shape, is not a fractal. It's not self-similar because it's not made up of smaller copies of itself, whereas the fern is a fractal because it's self-similar. Now, there are lots of examples of fractals in nature that you've seen all around you. One example is a mountain range. So a mountain range is made of, you can think of it's a big bump as a mountain, and on that big bump are smaller bumps that look like a mountain. So you have little mountains on top of the big mountain, and then smaller mountains on top of the small mountain, and so on and so on. And these little bumps on top of bumps, they don't look identical, but they look similar. So mountains are fractals. Another example of a fractal is a tree. This picture is of a sycamore tree. And you can see this branching structure, kind of like the fern, is repeated at several scales. That branches have smaller branches off of them that are similar to the main branch. And then those small branches have smaller branches still off of them, and so on. So the same shape, or the similar shape, repeats over many different scales. Another example is this Romanesco broccoli that has these spiral, green spiral shapes. And you can see that the broccoli is made up of green spirals. And those green spirals are made up of green spirals. And those green spirals are made up of smaller green spirals, and so on. So it would say that this Romanesco broccoli is a fractal as well. And just to give one more example, a vascular system. So here, these are the vascular system for this leaf. You can see that it has a nice fractal structure. The shaped branch, and then branch again, and branch again. And the veins and arteries inside of us, and inside of all mammals and creatures, also have this fractal structure. And we'll talk about the implications of that when we talk about metabolic scaling. So that's a short introduction to fractals. Fractals are self-similar objects. In the next several videos, I'll introduce some mathematical fractals, and you'll learn how to calculate their dimensions.